Hello and welcome to our sixth RISC-OS programming tutorial. Today we're going to be making a window appear on our screens. And in next tutorials we're going to fill it with icons, which is what we call in RISC-OS buttons and labels and all that. We call them all icons, unless they're pictures, and we call them sprites. But doesn't matter yet, windows to start with. So I'm going to create an empty C file and let's get going. So first thing we want to do is include oslib/wimp.h. What we're also going to need is to include the standard library, because we're going to have to do some memory allocation in this tutorial, stuff I showed in the last tutorial, and let's get started. Brilliant. So first thing we have to do is create our task handler and make our event number. So when we call wimp poll, it puts the type of event or the number of the event in this variable, and then we can use it to work out how to respond to stuff like clicks and open requests. You'll see. Let's not forget the wimp block. So that's where we're going to store our window, actually. We put everything in this block of memory that we want to talk to the wimp with. I'm just going to change that. I like a bit of consistency with my tabs. Lovely. And then os bool quit equals false. We don't want to quit yet. Brilliant. So the first step is to initialize our task and put the handler into our wimp task handler variable. So wimp initialize, and we want to put the wimp version underscore RO3. I'm going to call this one tutorial 6. This was originally going to be tutorial 5, but I changed it because I didn't think you knew enough C. Brilliant. So next thing we want to do is we want to define our window, actually. In fact, I'm going to put that here. We need some memory to put our window in. So we're going to have a new variable type called wimp window. Wimp window, and we're going to set that equal to a pointer, and we're going to call that pointer window. Lovely. So what we need to do now is build our window. So let's get that code up. First thing we want to do is we want to allocate memory to the window, and we need to work out how much memory to allocate to the window. So window equals malloc, then size of, and of course wimp underscore window. But what we also want to do is we might have icons in that window, and we need to store those icons in the window variable. So we're also going to have to add size of wimp underscore icon. So that's the size of one icon, and then times that by however many icons. Now we're actually putting no icons in our window, so I'm going to put 0 there. In the future when we add icons, we'll change that number to 1 or 2, depending on how many icons we're adding. So that's allocating enough memory for our window. Next thing that we're going to want to do is we're going to want to have a look at the different things we need to different variables we need to fill this window out with. So just like before, we're going to open our oslib help manual thing and go into wimp. Now let's find wimp window. There it is at the bottom. Lovely. So whoa, there's loads of stuff you've got to fill in for this. So let's look at them one at a time. So the first thing is this visible function. So window, we're using the arrow operator because window is a pointer. Visible and this is of type OS box, which is also, well, it's a struct, so dot again, x naught. I'm going to set that equal to 200. In fact, we'll set all of these and I'll explain what they are. Window visible dot y naught equals 200. Window visible dot x1 equals 400. And then window visible dot y1 equals 400. So what we're doing here is we're declaring the size of the window and where it's going to open, and this is the size of the visible window. So if you have a look, I can make this smaller, but the workspace is not any smaller because I can move and I can see all of it, but the visible window is. These are the OS coordinates of the four corners of our window. Next, we have Y scroll and X scroll. So that's the default position of the scroll bars. So window, arrow, X scroll. I'm going to set them equal to zero for now. Window. Don't want it to be open scrolled. Zero. I apologize if there are any spelling mistakes. Now this variable next. This is where our window is going to appear. And we want it to appear on top of all the other windows. We don't want it in any of the icon bars. We don't want it hidden or behind. We just want it to appear in the normal place. So we're going to go window, arrow, next, equals, wimp underscore top. Lovely. Next, we've got the window flags to look at. So window flags. Now there's a lot here. So do you remember when I talked about flags being binary numbers and we OR them? So 10 ORed with 01 is equal to 11 because we go that OR that 1, that OR that. And if we had 1, ooh, we're done. If I had 11 afterwards, that would be 1 because 1 OR 1, 1. That's what the OR operator is. So first thing to do, we want the window to be movable. So we're going to use that flag, wimp underscore window underscore move. Wimp underscore window underscore movable. It's difficult to type because my screen is twisted so that the camera can see the screen. Right, next. We want it to be auto-redrawn. We don't want to have to call the redraws ourselves. So you'll see what I mean later when we get onto filling our window with stuff. Wimp underscore window underscore auto underscore redraw. Move this out of the way. Going on to new line because there are just so many. Next thing we're going to want is we're going to want a back icon. There is. Oh no. Where do we want it? Back icon, down here. We can skip pretty much all of these. Back icon is next. So wimp underscore window underscore back underscore icon. Next, we want the close icon. It's called window underscore close underscore icon. So I'll show you what all these are. The back icon is this icon up here. So if I click that, you see the icon, the whole window goes to the back. The close icon is the close icon. Right, then wimp underscore window underscore title underscore icon. We call the title bar an icon. So we're just saying we do want a title bar. What else do we want? We want H scroll and V scroll. So that's just enabling the scroll bars. Wimp underscore window. Scroll and wimp underscore window underscore v scroll. I've missed one. We also want the toggle icon, which is I can't remember what half these icons are. You can experiment by taking some of these flags out and seeing what happens to the window. Window underscore toggle underscore icon. That's that one. That's the minimize icon, as it would be called in Windows. Then what we want is window underscore size underscore icon. So that's this icon that resizes windows like that. Put my window back to how it was. And finally, and most importantly, window underscore new underscore format. That's because I changed how these windows worked. And all of these flags are rendered useless unless you use the new format flag. Brilliant. So we've got our Windows flags in. Next, we need to set the different colours. Show you what I mean here. So we've got the title foreground, so that's the text colour of the title. The title background, the background. The work, which is this thing. Foreground and background. The scroll outer, which is this part. Background and this, which is the inner. And then the highlight, where is that? Highlight background, which I think is this colour we're seeing here, which is because I've got my caret, which is what that thing's called, inside this window. Brilliant, so let's get going. So, window title underscore fg equals wimp underscore colour, and it's spelled the British way, or the proper way, as I'd call it. The spelling of colour. Window, we want title underscore background equals wimp underscore colour underscore light grey, I think. Or very light grey, that's it. Very underscore. Is it? No. Just light grey. Light grey for this one. Light underscore grey. So that's light grey, this is very light grey. So window underscore, what are we going for now? Work underscore foreground, that's going to equal wimp underscore colour underscore black. Next, window arrow work underscore background. So we're going to go for very light grey this time. Wimp underscore colour underscore very underscore light underscore grey. Brilliant. So next, what we moved on to now. So we're on to the scroll outer, which we're going to make wimp underscore colour underscore mid underscore light underscore grey. I feel if they call this a mid light grey, I want to see what the dark greys look like. Because I'd call that dark grey. Scroll underscore inner. Inner. That's going to equal wimp underscore colour underscore very underscore light underscore grey. Finally, window highlight underscore background equals, I'm going to use red. I think it uses cream technically, but I really don't like that colour, so I'm just going to use red. It doesn't make much difference at the moment. Red. Ooh. Lovely. So, next we need to make the extent of the work area. So how big the work area is going to be. The work area is how big this window would be if it was just as big as we can make it. So, window. Extent. Now, what you can do is your little sort of homework, you can play around with these numbers and work out what they do. See if you can break it, see if you can make it better. Oh, forgot X there. Dot y naught equals minus 600. Window extent dot x1 equals 400. And window arrow extent dot y1 equals 0. So you can play around with these numbers, change the shape of everything and so on. I get these two confused. I may have got them confused in this tutorial, but don't worry, we won't actually be using this method of creating windows much longer. We'll be using template files. But I'm just showing you how the window works, how to make a window, so when it comes to icons, you'll have a better understanding of what's going on. So next, window dash title flags. Title flags. Brilliant. Oh, I've got my underscore. Title flags. Right, so let's set these. We don't actually use that many for the title. We're going to use wimp underscore icon underscore text. So that means there will be text. But all that with wimp underscore icon underscore h centered. So we want the text h centered, and then we'll go for wimp underscore icon underscore text. Oh no, that was the line above. V centered. Brilliant, that's all for those flags. Nowhere near as many as the window flags. And then finally, window dash work flags. If I remember correctly, yeah, work flags. And they are also icon flags. We're actually going to have only one flag for this. We want our work area to be clickable. So we're going to have wimp underscore button underscore click. But this isn't actually going to work on its own. It says shift by wimp underscore icon button type shift. And explain why that is. Sometimes the wimp poll, when it's telling you what's happened, other parts of the system, it will use button click as the value 3. But we don't want to put the value 3. We don't want to OR it with in the work icon flags. It shouldn't be 3. I think it should be 12. So we're going to have to shift it because we need to put our bit in a different place. So the system sees that as 3, which is 1, 1. We don't want it there. We want it to be 1, 1. That's where we want it. So we're going to shift it. And we're going to shift it by wimp. Ooh, wimp underscore. What did it tell me to shift it by? Icon button type shift. Icon underscore button underscore type underscore shift. Lovely. Icon button type shift. So when I'm sure I would have made loads of spelling errors. I'll be amazed if this compiles first time. Sprite area. That's what I'm going to do next. Get rid of this view. Sprite area. That's how you spell it. Got the underscore. I'm going to set that equal to 0. We're not going to use that as of yet. Now we need to set the X min and the X and the Y min. That's the minimum X and Y values that our window can be, the minimum size. Window X min equals naught. Window Y min equals naught. We're almost done. What have we got next? Right then. I'm going to introduce you to a new library, which is included in pretty much all C compilers, and it's called string.h. And what we need to do is we need to copy the text for our title into a certain area. In fact, I'll show you wimp icon data into here. And we're going to use a function called string copy, or string copy. And this takes three arguments. The first is the destination. So we're going for window icon underscore data dot text. Next, what we're going to put in there. So I'm going to put in tutorial 6. And finally, I need to put on in the limit. So if you look here, 12 is the limit. So we're going to tell it, if we put anything in here bigger than 12, we're going to stop copying after 12. Lovely. Finally, window icon underscore count equals 0. We've got no icons in the window. So we're going to set the icon count equals 0. We don't need to set any icons yet. That's going to be later. Now, you may notice that that is a huge amount of code just for setting up the window. And I don't really like doing that because I like to separate sort of the grunt work of a program and the what the actual program does, the algorithms in the program. So I'm going to do something different. Now, I disappeared for a sec and I made some changes to what we're doing. Now, the first thing I've done is I've created an extra folder, which is an H folder. And in this H folder, I've created this file, which is utils. Now, what a H stands for, that is a header file. And header files are files which other files can include. You'll notice that when we include standard lib, wimp, string, it's .h, and we're creating one of them, which our other files are going to include. And at the moment, it just declares that we have a function called build window, and that takes a pointer to a pointer of a wimp window. So if I go into my utils.c, you'll find I've built this function, and it is exactly what we've typed out, character by character. The only difference is I've added pointers and these brackets around every time window, apart from the first time. So the idea now is that when we go into our C file, we don't need to include all these things. We can just include utils.h, and we include these headers, and we include that function, and we can use it. So I've gone build window, then we put the address of our address of a window, or pointer to a pointer. Brilliant. Now we can carry on. So the next step, we're actually going to make, I think we're going to make another function here. And let's go into the oslib help, because there's something, I've already got it open. There's something we need to do, which is load our window into our block, into block.open. It's what we're going to be loading it into. I realise this is confusing. Using a SWI called wimp create window. So, brilliant. We're going to make a function to do this because we need to do this quite a lot actually. So we're going to go to load window into block. That's what our function will be called, and it's going to take in wimp window. Double points to that, and it's also going to take in wimp block pointer called block. Lovely. So now we need to implement this function. So we're going to copy this, and we're going to go into our utils.c file, and we're at the bottom. We're going to add that declaration, but take away the semicolon and put the normal curly brackets. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to call that software interrupt. So can you see that what it does is it returns something of type wimp w. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be setting this w in open inside our block. I'll show you what I mean. So what we're going to do is we're going to go block, arrow operator, because our wimp block is a pointer, open, so now we're in here in wimp open. Now we need to get to that w, so dot w. That is going to equal wimp underscore create underscore window. Window. And it takes in a wimp window. So What we need to do is we need to dereference our pointer to the window and just give it the window. Lovely. Now there's some more stuff we need to add. We need to add an OS box visible, scroll, and the next. And you'll think, well, hold on, we've declared all that stuff inside here, inside our window. Why do we need to do it again? And the reason why is simple. It's because what the window variable stores is it stores the default position of all of these. But the block is like dynamic memory. It's memory that changes. So when we move our window, we're changing the visible coordinates. And when we scroll our windows, we're changing the scroll coordinates. So this is the active variables. These ones will change. But since we're loading the window in new, we're going to put in the default values. So we're going to go block, visible, and we'll set that equal to window visible. Very easy there. Block, x scroll equals window x scroll. We'll do the same for block y scroll equals window. Ooh, up in there. Window y scroll. And finally, block next equals window next. Ooh, there we go. So that's going to be our load window into block function. So let's use it. Let's go into our main here and we're going to go load window into block. So first we need to put the address of our window. Second, we need to put the address of our block. Perfect. So now there's one more thing to do. Get rid of this, save that. Save this for good measure. I'm calling it tut6 because this is our sixth tutorial. We need to actually show the window. So let's have a look. Let's have a look at what. Here we go. Open window. So this is a SWI which returns nothing and it takes in WIMP open. And you'll remember if I go into my types, go into block, this open is of type WIMP open. So that's what we're going to pass to it. So we're going to show the window now. So let's do that. I'm going to go WIMP underscore open underscore window. And we want the address of block.open. That's going to open our window so we can all see it. And now, next, we're going to go into our WIMP poll. So we're going to need our loop while, oh, is that right? Yep, while. While not quit. Brilliant. So first thing we need to do is we're going to set event equal to WIMP underscore poll. And if you remember, our WIMP poll takes a few arguments. It takes the masks. We're going to put one in there. The reason why is because if I click here, you see this WIMP mask null. Of value 1. That's the only one we want. We only want, so this is, these flags are when we don't want the WIMP poll to hand us control. And if nothing has happened, we have nothing to do in the background. So we're not going to, look out for them. So we're going to put that mask in. Next, we need to put in the address to the block. Block. And finally, we need to put in null because we don't care about the poll word at the moment. And now we're going to make a switch statement on event. Lovely. So we're going to add in some, let's have a look at types. And we're going to go to WIMP event number here. Because there are some new types that we need to think about. The first one is open window request. So WIMP underscore open underscore window underscore request. Request. There we go. I forgot to put a case in front of it. Now, what we want to do here is we want to, this is whenever the WIMP manager tells us that we want to open the window. And we need to do this a lot, because actually whenever we move a window, it calls the open window request if we open the window in a different place. So we're going to call the same function we called here, wimp underscore open underscore window brackets. We want block dot open. Brilliant. And then break, so we don't go into the next one. The next one we want is case. And let's have a look down. We want close window request. So we want wimp underscore close underscore window underscore request. So this is whenever the X button is hit. So what we're going to want to do is we want to work out how to close our window. So let's have a look. See if we can, wimp close window. Perfect, that's what we need. So wimp underscore close underscore window, and it takes a wimp W. So let's have a look at our block, see what we can give it. That does it take, and it's not a pointer, that's important. Always check to see if it's a pointer. Types wimp block close, wimp close, let's have a look in there. Brilliant, it's got that. So we're going to go block dot close dot W. Perfect, that'll close the window. Now we also want it, because we haven't got an icon in the bottom corner yet, we want it so when we hit the X, the whole program closes. So we're going to go quit equals true. Lovely, and break that. Then we want the exact same thing we had last time. Case, wimp underscore, wimp underscore user underscore message, and case wimp underscore user underscore message underscore recorded. This time, quit equals true, and then break. Perfect. So that's our switch statement done. Finally, what we want to do is have our close down. So exactly the same as last time. We're going to look in our S2Is and wimp close down. That's what we're going to call. We're going to go wimp underscore close underscore down. And we're going to put in task, because that's our task handler. And finally, return zero. What we can also do, if you want to be good citizens, is we can free our window. But that doesn't really matter, because the task is about to stop. That will get rid of anything we have on the heap anyway, as far as I'm concerned. I might be wrong there, but I'm pretty sure it will. So let me show you how to compile this then. So because we have multiple files here, compiling this is a bit more complicated. So I'm going to open our shortcut we made last lesson, set the directory. And first thing we need to do is we need to compile each file individually. We're not going to link them, so we're going to use the dash C. So dash ioslib colon output for this one, we'll go for tut.o, and the input will be tut6.c. Now we'll see if I made any mistakes. I really hope not. come on. Oh dear. So line 8 and line 12. I've made mistakes. So let's have a look. Line 8. Oh, what's wrong with this? Ah, of course. That syntax is just completely wrong. I don't need the win equals there. Sorry about that. We're just declaring it. We're not setting anything equal to anything. Oh, sorry about that. We'll try that again. GCC dash C dash IOS lib colon dash o tut dot o, and it's tut 6 dot c. Try again. Well, I knew I'd make a mistake somewhere. I might have made more mistakes. Let's have a look. Oh, perfect, that worked. So now we need GCC dash c dash ios lib colon dash o utils dot o, and this is utils dot c. I don't need to compile the I put a zero instead of a dash. This is quite tedious, isn't it? I'm going to show you how to get around all of this just in a second. dash o utils dot o then utils dot c, and we don't need to compile header files because they're included in our C files, so they'll work anyway. Oh, so I've made some mistake here. Let's have a look. This is programming for you, just constant errors in function build window, line 35. Oh god. Line 35. Here we go. Member has WIMP window has no member named icon underscore data. Let's look. Get back into here. WIMP window. Let's have a look. Title data. I looked there. Title data, not icon data. That's why. Fair enough. You probably spotted that. Title data. Sorry if that made no sense. First time we went over it. Right. Then WIMP block has no member X scroll. Right, let's have a look. This is why I forgot to put the open. Really messed this one up, haven't I? Right, I'll show you what I've done there. I'll show you why I was wrong. If we go into WIMP block, it's WIMP block dot open, and then dot visible dot x scroll dot whatever. So sorry about that. Try it again. GCC dash c dash ios lib semicolon not yeah colon out so utils dot o and then utils dot c. Let's try again. I might edit those bit out. I just refuse to do this again. I've tried to record this so many times. In function, load window into block, warning assignment takes pointer from integer without cast. So line 40. I know. I spelt this wrong. Windon, window. There we go. That was the error. Try again. Jeez. Oh my god. Dash iOS lib colon. Right. What am I doing? Dash o utils dot o and then utils dot c. See if this works. GCC dash o run image, then we want utils dot o and tut dot o. It was just lowercase. I forgot to run image utils dot o and tut dot o, and then I need to link it dash l os lib 32. I'm gonna have a tough time editing this. Brilliant. So now that that's all happened, we eventually have this file. We open it and we have a lovely little tutorial window. It says tutorial 6 at the top, and when we close it, it disappears from our memory. But let's make that compiling a bit easier, because that was a lot. Let's make that a little easier. So what we're going to do is we're going to go and we're going to create... We're going to create a new obey file. And we're just going to write exactly what we would write normally. So GCC dash C dash iOS lib semicolon. Then what's our first file? tut6.c. Then our next file, actually, what we're going to do is we'll do an output dash o tut.o tut6.c. Then gcc dash c dash iOS lib colon dash o utils dot o, and then it's utils dot c, gcc dash o run image, and then we want our input files, that's tut dot o and utils dot o. Then what we want is we want to link it, so dash l I os lib colon and then dash l os lib 32. Brilliant. So finally we're going to use a new command, wipe, because we want to get rid of this o directory. It's not really useful to us, so we're going to wipe the o directory, and we're going to do this. So normally when you use wipe, it asks you for every single file and every single folder whether you're really sure you want to remove it. So we want to bypass that. So this is the confirm flag, and we're using that sign, squiggly line sign, to say no. So we're going to save this, we're going to call it make, and we're going to stick that in this directory. And I'm going to remove the O directory, and I'm going to remove our executable. Close this, and I'm going to go into our terminal, and I'm just going to write now make. I set the directory before, so I don't need to do it twice. Do make, and we'll leave it a little while. And brilliant. So it's told me what I've deleted, and I now have my file, and it works perfectly. Lovely. So I'll see you for tutorial 7 to add some icons to that window. Bye.